Well, it should be streaming right now, but I don't know. Let's find out by going to... What are you doing, cat? Bloody cat. It says offline. It says healthy. I'm healthy. It must be working. Go away, cat. Can't see it.
What?
This story is set back in time, about 100 years.
Anyway.
In this period, Japan was divided.
No audio now. None at all. Districts,
where each warlord was desperately trying to
expand his reign. You've got to be joking.
The roaring sound of war could be heard everywhere.
You take it.
Onin's battle in 1467 triggered a ruleless world.
Seriously, no sound.
Anarchy of power meant nothing. Anarchy was the only thing which could be found. But the arrival of a foreign ship, cast ashore by a storm on the distant southern island, influenced the war greatly.
Oh, you're right as well.
A mechanized soldier. Technology given by foreigners along with firearms enabled Japanese craftsmen to build an 8-meter-tall humanoid robot.
Where's this sound come from?
Powered by a steam engine. This machine was so powerful that each warrior could stand against 300 cavaliers. The airship was another invention brought by Westerners. It was no wonder that the highly sophisticated weapons spread throughout the country in no time. Countries which could not keep up with the rapid change lost their power and were absorbed in the powerful stream. In the year 1556, the names of the 8 strongest warlords who had survived this chaotic time were...
I can hear something.
Shingen Takeda, Kenshin Uesugi, Motonari Mori, Dosan Saito, Motochika Chosokabe, Takahisa Shimazu, Yoshimoto Imagawa. Especially Oda of the Owari district was expanding his power rapidly throughout the country because of his demonic talents. In April of 1556, Oda's ally Dosan Saito was murdered by his son Yoshitatsu, and the balance of power became unstable. At the time the news of Saito's death arrived at Oda's castle, the anti-Oda alliance was formed between the 6 most powerful warlords, Motonari Mori being the leader. In the vicinity of Mikawa, Imagawa's army executed a fierce attack on Oda's...
I think you're taking the piss there, because I can hear it.
Facing the absolute overwhelming power of the Imagawa force, the Shibata army was demolished.
Put some game volume on. Oh no. Oh, I'm knocking this all the way all over the place. There we go. I can't hear it myself now. Out of these pill things. This shit comes over here now. You fucker, you always go the opposite direction. If anybody's watching, can you hear anything? It says 2 people watching that. Oh, you fucker. I need the manga for this. Oh, that'd be old. I did like the yellow one. Hey! Darren must have been taking the piss then, because he said he can't hear anything. Or he's not got the sound turned up on his computer. You won't believe it's taken me nearly an hour and a half to actually get the sound working. I was getting massive... What is that bird thing? He's getting massive echoes, which I really struggled to get rid of. Forgive me if I don't reply to you very quickly. The monitor's actually behind me. It's Robo Alessi on the Sega Mega CD. I haven't bought it in... I don't think there's any copy part. There's no copy section on the... It's ripping the shit out of the carpet. There's no copy texting on the CD, so you just need an application to burn the ROMs off the internet. I downloaded a few, actually, and I was going to give them all a go. This is actually hard as nails. I've got! This one didn't work. So I've actually burned a few games and I don't know what I've done. I've not written on them what it is. So this is random disc number 2. And my telly goes to widescreen every single time it loses its signal for some reason. Yeah, it's not bad, Robo Alessi. It's bloody hard. I must say it's hard. I got to level 2 and died, and you can continue, but you continue with absolutely no power ups. You right? Oh, okay. Back in a second, the baby's awake. Oh my god, I turned this off. Back, and I've lost my controller. Here it is. Little lad just woke up, that's all. Yes, sorry, it's the Sega Multi Mega. I was very lucky. I got that for £45 because it said it wasn't working, and there's nothing wrong with it. Let's have a quick go with this. New game. I remember this was one of the big selling games when the Mega CD came out. It's a bit crap. I'll have a go at that in a minute. What do I do? Yeah, I wish I could do more videos. As you saw then, actually, even my little lad's got eczema, and it's better at the moment. But on a typical night, he's up every hour or so, scratching. It makes doing any videos or streaming quite difficult. Have you ever played this before? Because I remember this being a very big selling point on the Sega Mega CD, and now that I've played it, it's actually so dull. It's unbelievable how dull it is. Wait a second, I'll finish this lap, and then I'll... I need to have a setup here so I can read comments here. Unfortunately, my monitor's literally about 5 o'clock to me, so I've got to turn my head to see it. I thought this meant to have CD quality music, it's crap. It's also been drowned out by the awful sound of the engine. Fabulous. I've heard the Amiga version of this is actually a lot better than the Mega CD version. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to put on... So you've got Mega CD, do you actually buy your games legitimately, or have you copied some of them? Because I've got a few games, but consider all the really good ones cost a lot of money now. I've gone down the copying them route.
Metro City, a well-known crime capital, has been ruled by...
I'll leave this intro running because I think... If you remember the arcade and you listened to the laughter of the chap on the telly. Obviously it used to like resonate through the arcade every time it was on, but listen to it on this, it's laughable. Mad Gear controls all of the criminal activity in the city.
When they learned of Hagger's plans, they took an immediate... immediate action to bring this new mayor under their control. Sometime in 1992.
Hello, Mike Hager here.
Mr. Hager. So pleased to make your acquaintance.
I've only got three games as well.
Don't hang up.
Solo Fierce, Cobra Command, and Wolf Child.
Your daughter for your cooperation.
Here we go.
And throw in the regular monthly bonus for salary we offered before.
What? What happened to Jessica? Who is this?
Not so fast, Mike. Turn on your TV.
You son of a... What have you done to her?
That sounds very concerned.
Nothing yet. But we'd enjoy the opportunity. Listen to reason, man. Why make your job difficult? Just let us do as we please, like the mayor before you did.
Oh, I didn't hear it. I'm sure it's went ha 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 ha.
Anyway.
I thought I was going to look at the options.
That'll do.
Are they any good? No, it's not as bad as I thought it was, actually. I thought, I saw a bit ages ago. And the bit where they get the character on the telly starts laughing. He said, like, the screaming laughing in the arcade, literally just went, ha 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 ha. It was quite funny. Yeah, the music's different because it's all redone CD music, isn't it? What the FMV games like? The only one I've got really is Cobra Command. I remember when it was my birthday back in 1992. Yeah, it would have been 1992 because I went to Games Master Live at the NEC. And I remember it was a big thing about the Mega CD coming out, and they were giving out video cassettes. Like a 15, it was basically a 15 minute advert for the Mega CD. And I remember seeing Sewer Shark on it. I'm thinking it looked absolutely amazing. I used to play it over and over and over. When you got the character, is it called dog meat or something? Do you call your dog meat? Like, bring it on, dog meat. And you had watch my video. What was it called? What? Make my video, wasn't it? Crisscross, make my video. Used to think it looks amazing, but there's probably absolutely no gameplay in it. You little shit. Yeah. The video probably was from Mean Machines, because I used to get that as well. I think I picked it up when I was at Games Master Live. I think it was just basically a big pile of them, you just help yourself to them. Yeah, I presume it's called Dog Meat. I've never actually played it, I've only seen bits. It's taken a long time to load. Never actually played it, but doesn't your character get a definite nickname depending upon how well you're doing or how far into the game you are? Like, you get called dog meat, and then later on you get called something else. Cheesy 90s guitar music, isn't it? Sounds like it could be an episode of Midnight Caller or Equalizer. I watched someone play Sewer Shark, and it was, it's like, if you see something at the bottom of the screen, don't get killed. Like the arrows, when you have to press B and then pull the direction to actually then change the direction, and if you didn't do it on time, you basically meant like head on into like a brick wall or something, or a door. I think at the time, it's one of those things, was it's new, it's something new we can do, let's make games out of it, regardless whether it was actually any good for a game or not. It's only in hindsight you can actually say, yeah, it was actually shit. Ah, you can tell this is the Western release, because the prostitutes have got cycle shorts on. Poison and Roxy. I used to hammer the coins at this, and when I was little. I think it's kind of lost some of its charm now it's got CD music, to be honest. Oh, wasn't watching. I've recently been to a arcade club. I don't know whereabouts you're from. But in Bury, there's the arcade club, which is apparently now is Europe's biggest arcade. I've been a few times now. Great fun. I went with me mates a couple of weeks ago. Basically got there at 9 o'clock and left at like 1 o'clock in the bloody morning. Kicking out time. Didn't realise it was that time until. Whoa. Yeah, they got told you we've got a few minutes left. But everything's on free play, and I played this. And to be honest, it took a little bit of the enjoyment out of it. It being free play, because all these games could easily be finished if you had enough money. I mean, the challenge was at the time is can you finish it with 20p, 50p, a quid, or whatever, how many continues. But when you actually continue as much as you want, it kind of takes a lot of the challenge out of it, to be honest. Oh, compared to the ports, it was probably the best port. This actually was. But when I went back and actually looked at some of these games, especially the 80s and 90s one, because a lot of them, obviously, you can set how difficult it is. And it's obvious to me now is how much the games were just geared towards making you stick more money in. Now, the example I've just given, well, one example I'll give is they had Operation Wolf there, which I absolutely love. I'm sure everyone's got really good memories of Operation Wolf. But I couldn't get past the second level in the jungle. Because the difficulty, I think the difficulty has been set up on the dip switches. Basically, loads of times I would get towards the end. I remember looking at it and it said, I was at the end and it said they've got 15 men left, a tank and two boats. And I had about 4 or 5 health bars left. And all of a sudden, the screen was filled probably with every single character, two tanks and a boat, or tank and two boats, and I literally lost probably 4 or 5 health points straight away. And I tried probably about a dozen times, and I didn't get past that level because I got so far, did really, really well, and literally when it said that, when I got less than 20 characters left, they literally all piled on the screen at once. And I kind of understand why mum and dad got like a bit peeved off when I kept asking for money. Me and my friend did Night of the Living Dead 2, I think it was. House of the Rising, no, House of the Living Dead. No, what's the Sega shooter one? House of the Living Dead 2, I think it was. He said he's never finished it. He said one of his favourite games, he's never finished it. So we played it till we finished it. And the last couple of levels, you were talking about bosses which are nigh on impossible to hit, and insta-killed you when they hit you. And you must press continue a dozen times at the least, just like in the last level. And you think that was 50p, it's like 6 quid, just on the last boss. It's a good laugh though, still really good playing the old games and stuff. House of the Dead, yes. I think I'll get like a few games mixed up there. It's House of the Dead 2. Let me catch up. Yeah, it is like every game, you've got to play it to get good, but and you know yourself, you can actually set the difficulty of arcade games in dip switches and whatnot. And it, to me, it shows if you set it to the hardest setting, one of the hardest settings, the game is designed to just not even give you a chance. I've played Operation Wolf several times and I've got past that level, but that one is just can't do it. Just set way too well. So whereabouts are you from then? If you're gonna plan to go to arcade football, please.
No, it's not that bad, is it? It is really good, actually. There's lots of machines there. And they're changing quite regularly. I think I've been 4 times, and they don't change every machine, but if you go like once a month, there'd be like 4 or 5 machines they've taken out and put in. And one thing I actually do like about it is it's just like the cost of drinks and beer. I think mate got a bottle of Bud or Beck's or whatever. I mean, only like £2. And if you don't drink like me, a can of Coke's 50p. It's good that they don't rip you off when you're in there. Yeah, I can't remember which night it is. I think it's either Saturday night or a Friday night. It's over 18s only. To be honest, there's quite a few kids there when I went. There was but they weren't that bad. They didn't get in the way or anything like that. Oh, they've also got the PlayStation VR there. They did have an Oculus Rift. Probably the smelliest Oculus Rift in history. It's been used by any sweaty sod. But they got replaced with the PlayStation VR, if you're interested in that. I think they had Eve Valkyrie. I didn't get to go on it last time I went. There's always a bit of a queue for it. There was a sword over there. Ah. Didn't last a while. I don't know why there's CD seeks in the middle of a track. Just keep stopping the music. That sign and get some out of it. Give me food. Turkey, perfect. Yeah, hot dogs and burgers are like, I think it's £1.50 for a small hot dog or for a large one as well. Not the best burgers in the world, the best hot dogs in the world, but I just want something to eat. Things like packets of crisp and Mars bars are like 50p. And they got like retro sweets as well, like large cola bottles, which I love. And they're selling for 10p each, and I'm like, stopping it when I'm going out. It is a good thing, and I hope they do well. I think one thing it highlights to me is how much work it must be to keep these machines active. One of the first couple of times I went, I played the Star Wars machine. It's the good old-fashioned sit-down cab one. And then I went again a few weeks later, and unfortunately, one of the buttons on the triggers was snapped off. Do you mean? And this, I've heard that machine's valued at like £4,000-£5,000 because of the condition it's in. And he doesn't do it to collect it, he does it so people can keep playing the machines, and unfortunately, either by accident or someone messing around, one of the buttons got snapped. And there's lots of other things like some of the other machines, like the some buttons don't work, or they're way too... I think I played Street Fighter 3 and you literally lightly touch the buttons and it does the action. And some of the things like the screens are going and stuff like that. It does show how much work it is now to keep these things active. Are you two going to be stuck in the corner now? Pretty sure this never happened in the arcade. Well, that was easy. It's been going for well over a year. It's been in Bury for a year. I think before that it was somewhere near Clitheroe, like top of Blackburn Burnley way. Ain't gonna last very long with this much health. Ah, it's gone. It was there for a couple of years. It was quite a small place, and if you actually have a look when you go. You'll park in the car park, and basically the arcade club is the top floor of this like warehouse. But if you actually have a look at the floor below it, look in the windows and the floor below, you can see like arcade cabinets opening and stuff like that, obviously repairing them and maintaining them and stuff like that. And just storing them. It must cost a lot of money to rent that place out and power them and repair them and whatnot. I won't have to begrudge them if they actually charge more for the food and whatnot. Because I think everybody who works here is a volunteer. Yeah, the old venue, it was literally in the middle of nowhere. But at least now you just get off the M60 or the M66. It's one of the two. It's literally, once you get the motorway, it's 5 minutes away. Did you drop the gum? Yeah. Can you eat the gum to get... Whoa! Piss off. Anyway, I think one more random CD. Then I'll have to call it a night, I think. Which one have I tried? Let's try this one. I should have written on what it were when I burned it. Oh, for God's sake. One. No, it's not off the M62. It's, what you do is you'll go on the M62, then go on the M60, which goes round. The side of Manchester. Then I think you're going to the M66 for literally two junctions. So I think where you're coming from, you go M62, M60, M66. Oh, it's this. The track playing in the ring sounds good. What does that mean? I don't know. I think I missed what that was. Here we go. I think I watched the demo of this when I tested the disc. It's Very typical.
What were you doing while they were stealing the key from us? You went to get a snack, you fool.
Ow! You don't have to get so upset about a dinky key.
You don't understand anything. It was Dr. Boone who stole it from us. A super intelligent raccoon. His IQ is 1400. Can you even guess how important that key is?
Well, what is the key for?
It's for the secret treasure.
Then what is the secret treasure, Grandma?
Don't ask so many questions! The only thing I remember is... it's called Ark.
Ark? I wonder what it is.
Dr. Boone wants to use the Ark to turn this planet into a raccoon world.
Hey, why not? Sounds like fun.
What a fool you are. It was totally your fault. You know that. You really should... I guess you'll never learn. Well, listen, Rami.
Oh, it does look odd. I've got to level 2 and you get a screenshot of that blue thing. Complete with scrotum.
No key, no dinner. You better.
Why it needs the scrotum to be drawn on it, I don't know.
Hey, Spot, we gotta go. Spot, are you still sleeping? Wake up!
Fucking hell. She's... how cruelty or what? Let's see if we can get level 2. It's actually quite hard. But yeah, like the cutscene, you literally get a picture of view behind. That thing's now turned green. Come on, that one. It's good music, I must say that. Flying raccoons in there. Raccoons rowing flying boats. Why not? Raccoons riding frogs. Shitting out. Oh, fuck's sake, please. That's what I wanted, that bird thing. So I'm not talking, I'm just concentrating a lot. Yes, it is KO Flying Squadron, whatever it's called. Is it loading or is it crashed? I think it's crashed. The disc's not turning. I think I'll leave it there. Thanks for watching, mate. Now I've got the sound sorted out. I think I'll probably try this a bit more often. Cheers, mate. I'll hope you enjoy Arcade Club. And upload some more stuff yourself as well, actually. See you later.